Assalamu alaikum. Welcome back to the YouTube channel, and we're gonna review this Disney trailer.
No one told you to say all that extra stuff. You were just supposed to say the intro.
But I wanted to say.
There is a Disney movie out. It's a short film out called The American Eid, and it's exactly what it sounds like to be. I sort of seen it earlier, but I wanted to get my wife involved because we have two girls, two daughters of our own, and it's about two sisters. So, without further ado, let's jump into this review.
In Pakistan, Eid is a very special holiday for Muslims.
We don't get holidays for Eid.
I wonder if it's a real accent.
You and Zainab still have to go to school.
You said America will be good for our future? It's just 3 days.
No one cares.
So they're from Pakistan?
Yes, they're from Pakistan.
You had to wear that to school?
Maybe she's embarrassed of her sister.
Wait, the sisters come from Pakistan?
I think.
My sister Zainab, so we can get days off for Eid. Would you please come with me?
Is it based on a true story?
I have no idea.
Is that why we got the holiday?
I don't know. Oh, she gave me pinky promises.
I didn't really get much information.
I don't know, but everyone in the comment section is just like, I'm crying watching this trailer. I don't know. People seem really emotional from this 1:48.
I mean,
second.
I know in the UK they don't get Eid off. So maybe they would be emotional, but in America, in New York, Eid has been off for a couple of years now.
Yeah, in New York City, we've been giving Eid off, one day off, not all 3 days off. Like, you're bugging to think that you get all 3 days off. Like, come on. All right, little sister, you get one day off, not all three, bro.
They want the whole month.
Bro, she's talking about Eid al-Adha. She's not even talking about Eid al-Fitr. So,
but
this is the problem. If you're releasing it on this Eid, Disney, you know, you're saying 3 days of Eid, that's Eid al-Adha, not Eid al-Fitr. Eid al-Fitr for Ramadan, the Ramadan Eid, as you may know, as they call it in Pakistan, Chhoti Eid, right? It's one day, right? Badi Eid, as they call
it. Can I watch it again? Because I just feel like
let's run it back one more time.
In Pakistan, Eid is a very special.
Oh, she has a calendar like we do.
Yeah, they're showing a Ramadan calendar.
Exactly. You see? Problematic,
yeah,
Disney.
They made a boo-boo.
That's
there.
A boo-boo, Disney.
America will be good for our future.
They got... Well, who's that? Is that Nasiruddin Shah?
Nah, that's some other people.
You had to wear that to school?
Sister's embarrassed of her.
She's trying to make a stand, isn't it?
Yeah.
About her culture and stuff.
For me and my sister Zainab, so we can get days off.
Zainab's embarrassed to be Pakistani.
Yeah. You gotta be proud to be Pakistani.
Zainab's trying to become like, you know, westernized.
Gora.
Yeah.
She's gori.
The younger sister's like,
she's trying to hold on to her culture.
May 28th.
Yeah, so I don't know. What are your thoughts about this?
It looks interesting. I guess we got to see it. I just sometimes feel like Disney does like throw in some random stuff in there.
They're dodgy. They're dodgy.
So I'm not saying anything until I see it. And I'm definitely not going to like watch it in cinema or anything.
No. It's on Disney Plus.
Well, I'm not paying to watch it.
We're not going to.
I'm waiting for the free version.
But it looks like it's something that's positive. I'd also add that Disney is the same people who use Xinjiang for Mulan. They filmed over there, right? Yeah, with the Uyghur Muslims who are in these concentration camps.
Yeah.
And Disney used them in their production too. Like, they filmed over
and
there
they
giving them the
out
economy.
And then they said, no, they didn't.
Yeah, so, I mean, these are the same people who've in every single movie has, like, some type of magic, shirk, and all that sort of stuff going on. So, like, I don't trust them as far as I could throw them.
It'll be interesting to see what they portray. Because this could either be negative for Pakistanis.
Yeah.
Or it could just be negative.
So, it's also a breath of fresh air. Like, I do like seeing the fact that they're portraying in a more positive manner.
There's
some
Desi people.
There's some Desi representation. Also, it seems, from the trailer at least, that it seems like it's going to be something good, inshallah. Just because, think about it. You've seen the Hulu version of, you know, the moderate Muslim who's struggling with their deen, right? And they're doing all up to all these craziness. Then we've seen Apple Plus, where the girl Hala, who takes off her hijab, it's all about the liberation. Then we seen on Netflix what they were doing with
the
pedophilia.
Why can't they represent real Muslims?
But this is what I'm saying.
Why is it
this
always
seems,
extreme version?
This seems like this is a real Muslim Pakistani migrant family. And then you seen what they did on Netflix with the pedophilia of the Cuties movie. You remember that?
Oh,
so it just seems like the representation is coming from different production houses instead of Muslim production houses.
Like, is there any names? Is there like Desi names?
I was looking on Twitter and I think that the writer of it was a Pakistani Muslim. So that's a good sign.
Yeah,
that's a really good sign.
Let's see. Let's wait until after the 28th.
Yeah, let's wait to see what's happening over here, and maybe we'll review the movie after.
We didn't really get a perspective or anything apart from they're trying to show that she's trying to get Eid off. Yeah. And obviously they did a boo-boo where they're showing Ramadan and then they're showing...
There's a mistake. There's a huge mistake in the movie. There's a huge mistake in the movie already that we fall just from the trailer itself too.
I mean, unless it's that's one scene and then they're showing the second
maybe,
Eid.
I don't know.
Like maybe she didn't get the first Eid off. We don't want to shoot it down before we even...
But we're proud of the writers. If you're a Muslim Pakistani writer out there, you did this movie, mashallah, good for you. But you know what? I am happy that there is some Pakistani representation, some Muslim representation on Disney. And perhaps this makes someone interested in learning more about Eid, more about Ramadan or something.
Maybe,
But, you know, one solution out there for all Muslim households out there, when it comes to Eid, if you don't have off, do me a favor and just take off. Right? Because in New York City, one of the main reasons that they had to, by the way, if you don't know, give us off was because Muslims just stopped sending their kids. And their attendance rates were horrible, horrible. So I think that one of the biggest stands that we can take besides getting involved in petitions, which I think is a great option, I think one of the best things that we can do is just stop sending our kids to school on Eid. And if you do send them to school, send them in their Eid clothes. Why not? I think that'd be pretty dope. Send them with their Eid clothes. I think that the girl has the right idea with that. She has the henna on, the mandi.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's pretty dope. If you're watching this with your children, if you plan on watching it, make sure that you supervise them. So that you watch it with them and you're able to answer the questions in case there are some mistakes in the movie that you're able to correct them. But don't just let your kids just watch it like that. Yeah, I think that's a bad idea.
There's a lot of kids' shows and things, and if you watch a little bit of it, it seems okay. But if you actually watch the full episode, there are some things that they've thrown in that are inappropriate.
Be careful.
And like my kids are like watching stuff and I'm literally sitting there doing my own thing, but I can hear it in the background. And sometimes I've picked up on things that are inappropriate and I'm like, right, we're not watching this show again. And alhamdulillah, with my girls, if you tell them you're not watching this show, they don't watch it.
They understand.
They get it. Like, there's something not right.
Now, here's my question about Disney, right? I'm hearing they're like a Zionist company and all that sort of stuff. They're supporting Israel and all that. So are we supporting Israel and Zionism by watching this movie? I'd love to hear people's thoughts in the comment section below.
I mean, personally, I think that goes for Bollywood as well then.
Ah, man, it's just so many things.
Yeah, it's everything. It's tied into a lot of things. So we just have to be careful.
We have to be very careful.
We got to check the barcodes of things that we're purchasing.
And obviously, we want to hear your thoughts in the comment section below. What are your thoughts about this whole trailer, watching it with us as well? How do you think it's going to be? I'm just so skeptical of the representation that I can't just get so excited because I know this is the plan. This is the plan of the people.
It's like they're never going to want to do anything nice for the Muslims, are they?
So
like, that's how
see.
I feel.
Let's see. Let's see what happens. I think the next video that we make, inshallah, might be a review of the movie. Maybe
in
detail breakdown.
It's like they always
breakdown.
Have a hidden agenda.
Tell us also about the sponsor of today's video, our partners. Come on. Who's our partners? What my lovely wife meant was shout out to our partners in crime, Qur'anly. Download this app today to become addicted to reading the Qur'an. Link is in the description.
Thank you for watching and please come back and watch the next video.
Maybe.
And it was lovely having you join us today. And
this is the nicest touch ever.
Hope you appreciated the insight we gave you about this Disney trailer that...
Hopefully.
You know, might be good, might not be good when the movie comes out, but please let us know in the comments if there's any other questions you have regarding the trailer.
Okay, this is the funniest outro and the best and kindest outro I've ever had.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
May Allah bless you.
That's it. Assalamu alaikum.